Good morning, Lowell High School. It is Monday, January 25th, 2021, and you're watching The Week Ahead. Coming up, a look at The Review, Lowell High's newspaper, the Did You Pay Attention Question of the Week, and this week's staff shout-out. That's today on The Week Ahead. Thank you for joining me on this special remote edition of The Week Ahead. As we gear up for a return to in-person learning, I thought I'd take a walk through the quiet halls of Lowell High School. This place just isn't the same without you, and I'm anxiously awaiting for these halls to fill up with our great students. We begin our weekly episode with an interview with Kindling Kit and Natasha Watts from the LHS Review, our school newspaper. Take a look at what they've been up to. Natasha, if you just wouldn't mind talking a little bit about yourself, how many years you've been at Lowell High School.
I'm a junior at Lowell High School, and I am not entirely sure what I want to do after college. We were just talking about this before. I kind of want to go into journalism, kind of want to go into business.
And Kimling, tell us a little bit about yourself.
So my name is Kimling Kidd, and I'm a junior at Lowell High School. So far, my favorite classes, I am a math person, so I like calculus and science, and I'm planning on majoring in computer science when I go to college or do something STEM related.
Natasha, tell us a little bit about the Review. What is it? For those people who aren't familiar with it, can you give us an overview of what this publication is all about?
Yeah, so the Review is the school's newspaper, the LHS Review. We're less like CNN or Fox News. It's a lot more into the arts. Like, we have a lot of poetry published. We're working on some podcasts, a lot of creative stories, like short stories. We do definitely incorporate, like world news and politics into the paper though.
And Natasha, what are some of the ways that the newspaper is distributed across the school community?
So we don't have a printed paper, but we have our website, thelhsreview.com, and we also run our Instagram at LHSReview.
And Kimling, if students want to submit an article or a piece of work to the LHS Review, how would they do that?
We have our Instagram, like Natasha said, and they can always DM us or email Mr. Newcomb and give us the story, and we'll look at it and then post it up.
Is there a way that if students are currently not involved in the LHS Review newspaper that they can join?
They can email Mr. Newcomb or go to our Instagram and DM the staff, and then we'll let them in.
Well, Natasha and Kimling, I really want to thank you for being on the show today. Do you have any final words that you'd like to say to our school community?
All I have to say is just thank you for having us on the show.
You're more than welcome, and thank you for joining. Well, that concludes our interview. I really appreciate it. I hope you guys are doing well, and if you guys need anything, you know where to find me.
The athletic department has announced that the Fall 2 season is open for registration. This special season offers girls swim and dive, boys and girls indoor track, cheerleading, and football. Tryouts and practices are scheduled to begin on Monday, February 22nd. Go to lowellathletics.org and click on the Athletics Registration tab to sign up. In recent months, MHAS has been scheduled, coordinated, and then postponed due to the COVID-19 pandemic. As it stands now, there are no MCAS tests scheduled for high school students, but it's currently expected that ELA and math tests will be scheduled sometime in May. We'll continue to keep you posted as we hear more information. Seniors, the deadline to order your yearbook is now March 1st. The cost is $69.30, and the link to purchase can be found on the LHS homepage. Heads up, juniors and seniors, the deadline for applying to the early college program for the spring semester has been extended. You now have until February 1st to apply. For more information, click on the Distinctive Programs tab of the LHS website page. Did you pay attention? And now it's time to find out if you paid attention. In last week's show, I lost my train of thought in a daydream. Tell me, what was I daydreaming about last week? Email me the right answer and you'll get a $5 gift card to Dunkin' Donuts mailed directly to your house. For this week's staff shout-out, we honor Mr. Thomas Thornton, the Director of Student Activities. Simply put, Mr. Thornton is all about the students here at LHS. His work as the Activities Director has him overseeing our many after-school programs, and we have a lot, while also planning out fun activities and events and helping out with the Student Advisory Council. Mr. Thornton has a passion for traveling and loves taking his LHS students on class trips around the world. He's also willing to do whatever it takes to get things done, even if it means dressing up as Santa Claus. Mr. Thornton, thank you for your hard work and dedication on behalf of all of our students here at LHS. Well, that does it for today's show, and thank you for watching. I'll see you next week with another installment of The Week Ahead. Have a great week, everybody.
The Week Ahead with Mr. Fiato is made possible by Quirk Auto Dealers. Visit QuirkCars.com.